Good day from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to Space Station Live. You're looking now inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room, located at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Inside the room right now, the Orbit 2 team on console, taking a quick break while we wait for satellite handover to regain communication with the International Space Station. In the room a little bit later, you'll see they are being led today by Flight Director Tomas Gonzalez-Torres, and at the CAPCOM position this morning will be Mark Vandehei. The crew on board the International Space Station, Expedition 38, led by Russian cosmonaut Oleg Kotov. You can see the six-man international crew here, three of which on the left side there, the three newer crew members to launch to the station. They are Russian Mikhail Turin, NASA astronaut Rick Mastracchio, and Japanese astronaut Koichi Wakata. There on the right side, we have Russian cosmonaut Sergei Rozansky, Commander Oleg Kotov there in the front, and all the way on the right, another NASA astronaut, Mike Hopkins. On board the International Space Station, the crew starting off a busy week. Commander Oleg Kotov began his mornings fixing a number of sensors to his body as he begins a 24-hour series of recording using an electrocardiogram on board the International Space Station. The astronauts serving as test subjects for a wide array of biological experiments during their expedition space flights. He'll also be doing some scheduled routine maintenance throughout the Russian service module, also known as VESDA, working on some of the ventilation systems and also the intercoms. Meanwhile, his fellow Russian cosmonaut Sergei Rozansky will be doing some plug-in checkouts throughout the entire Russian segment today, also doing some acoustic sound level testing as they test the noise levels throughout various station structures to make sure that they're at healthy levels for the crews on board with all the equipment and other devices running pretty much nonstop up there for them. Meanwhile, NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins is operating the station's ultrasound system on board today for an ongoing study known as CardioOx. He'll be doing the ultrasound scans on JAXA astronaut Koichi Wakata. CardioOx looking to provide a better understanding for researchers down here on the ground of any space-related cardiovascular disease risk. The study looking to identify any of the potential indicators of increased health risk both during and after the long-duration space flight for all of these astronauts. Hopkins also today working on the waste and hygiene compartment. He was replacing an air filter. You can see a quick look at that here. The air filter had been past its lifetime, so he was doing a quick removal and replacement work on that today. And then towards the end of his day today, he'll be doing some leak checks on the Japanese experiment module's airlock following a depressurization by flight controllers in Japan's Tsukuba Flight Control Center. That airlock being depressurized in Kibo in advance of tomorrow's deployment of three of the four CubeSat nano satellites on board the International Space Station. Again, all that taking out of the Japanese experiment module. Third Russian cosmonaut, Mikhail Turin, doing some software upgrades on various Russian segment computers today. Also doing a checkout of the TORU and relocation simulator. The TORU, the teleoperator control module panel, you can see there used for manual control of visiting vehicles like the Progress, giving the cosmonauts on board the ability to intervene and take manual control should their automated core system get any hiccups or fail for any reason. So Turin doing a checkout of the simulator located on board, giving the cosmonauts the ability to hone their skills and prepare for any visiting vehicles. Meanwhile, NASA astronaut Rick Mastracchio, right upon waking up today, took a few saliva samples and stored them inside of Melfi, the minus 80 degree laboratory freezer on board the station. He'll also be working with some of the EVA or spacewalking tools today, installing a torque analyzer kit on what's known as the pistol grip tool, kind of the drill that the astronauts use during their spacewalks. He'll be installing that analyzer kit, which is able to gather data for further analysis down here on the ground. And the final Expedition 38 crew member, Koichi Wakata, again served as a subject for that CardioOx scan earlier this morning. The scan being conducted by Mike Hopkins. You can see Wakata inside of the Destiny Laboratory here, setting up for that scan earlier today. He'll also be setting up and performing a few checkouts on a new 4K HD camera that's been flown to the International Space Station. It'll be used throughout Wakanda's time on board and beyond to record super high-resolution Earth views, and also various celestial scenes for the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency, among those including the comet Izon's transit once it begins its closest path to the Earth later this month and in early December.